Let me show you an easy way how you can backup your n8n workflows to GitHub. We will start with creating credentials for GitHub. So for this purpose, you need to copy your authentication URL from n8n and go to your GitHub account to developer settings and create new app for authentication. So go to authentication apps and register new app. I will call my app n8n, and as a callback URL, you need to paste the address that we just copied from n8n, and as a homepage URL, simply paste the address of your n8n instance. Now just copy client ID and paste it into the field client ID in n8n credentials. Now you need to also generate client secret, so click generate client secret, copy it and paste it into the field client secret. After clicking connect my account, you should see a window where you need to authorize GitHub to do operations in n8n, so simply click authorize and you can close this window. Now you need to create a GitHub repository. So go to your GitHub account, click create repository and name your repository. In my case, it's n8n workflows backup. I will make my repository private, and after that you can click create repository. That's all. Finally, we need to create n8n credentials because we will use n8n API. So go to your n8n settings and generate new API key. Now go to credentials tab, click add credential and search for n8n API. Then you need to paste your API key in the first field, and as a base URL you need to point to the address of your n8n instance. In my case it's n8nbackup.workflows.com. To make your endpoint work, you need to also add API version 1 to the address. Now let's add a backup workflow. I already have 3 workflows that I want to backup to my GitHub repository, and I will create a backup workflow to send them to this repository every time I activate the workflow. I've prepared already this workflow, and let me show you how it works. First, this workflow generates date and time, and it will be used later as a commit message for our backups. Then it lists all the files that are currently in the repository that we want to send our backups to. And as you can see, right now we've got an error because this repository is empty. It's true, because there is nothing in this repository. So we will create an example file. In my case, it will be empty example JSON file, and I will commit the changes. Right now, when we execute this node, we should see that this file is listed. So let's quickly get back to our workflow and execute GitHub node once again. And yes, you can see that we have here our example JSON file. Now I want to a bit transform the output of the GitHub node, so I will combine all the items that come out from this node and I will store it in a single array. Now we want to get all the workflows that are saved in our n8n instance. So we will execute n8n node, and as you can see in output we see 4 items. Those are the 3 workflows that you saw before on the list, and the 4th one is the backup workflow that we create right now. Now we want to move those JSON outputs to binary. So we will use for it move to binary node, and as a file name I create combination of name of the workflow and ID, so every single file has a very unique file name. And finally comes the crucial part of this workflow. So here workflow checks if the file already exists in a repository. If it exists, it will create a new version of this file, and if it doesn't exist, it will simply upload it to the GitHub repository. Right now I will go to workflow settings to activate the option of saving manual executions, because we will activate this workflow manually. But you can also add your own trigger, for example, schedule trigger to execute this workflow every week, every day, just how you want it. So now when we saved this workflow, we can execute it, and let's go to execution tab. After a few seconds, you should see the result of this workflow. As you remember, our repository was empty. There was only one file and it was empty example.json file. But right now you can see that this workflow added the 4 workflows that we store in our n8n instance. So when we refresh this repository, we can see that all the workflows have been backupped. Let's right now add a new workflow and see if this backup workflow will add it to the GitHub repository. So I will create a new workflow and I will name it new workflow. And I will add only one node, which is webhook node. So I can now save it and close it. Let's get back right now to the workflow that creates the backups of our n8n workflows. Right now when we execute it, it should add to the GitHub repository the new file with configuration of newly added workflow. So let's execute the workflow, and after a few seconds you should see in the result that one item has been uploaded to the GitHub repository. And yes, when we refresh the list of files in our GitHub repository, you should see new workflow on the list. But how you can restore the backup from GitHub repository? Right now I will delete the second workflow, and when we go to the list of my workflows, you can see that this workflow doesn't exist in the library. So I will go to the backup in GitHub, click copy by JSON file, create new workflow in n8n and simply paste it on the canvas. To keep things clean, I will also rename it to second workflow and save the workflow. And yes, this is just as easy as you see. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, give thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and to my newsletter, link in the description, and see you in the next video. Bye!